My sister and I, we lost our mom. She was actually 38 years old. I was 9 and she was 3. My sister was 3 years old at the time, and we got evacuated out of Bosnia for medical reasons. We were in a gas explosion. At the time, Bosnia was going through war. They didn't have enough medical necessities to get us cured and to get the infection under control, so they decided to let us go to a different country. Thankfully, we escaped and we were sent to Italy. And in Italy, we got the care that we needed, but unfortunately, the day of arrival, our mother passed away. My sister became almost like a kid to me because I felt like I was the older sibling. I was her mother figure. Mother was not there, so she looked up to me as her own mother. And to this day, we still have that type of relationship. At the time when we were in Italy, the government had let us be adopted out, basically, because our father was still back in the country. He was a soldier, so he couldn't get out of Bosnia at the time. He had traveled to Italy and had asked the government, well, you guys have adopted my girls out without my permission. The government allowed us to go back into his care, but under the assumption that we would go to a third country, not Bosnia. So we had found out that a couple of aunts and uncles had moved to Fargo, North Dakota. One of our aunts got into contact with us in Italy and said, you know, you guys could come live with us. And that's exactly what happened. She came in and got us out of Italy and brought us to Fargo, North Dakota. I'm so grateful that they moved us here because this community has given us so much. And through my whole childhood, you know, living in the United States, I have been helped out by United Way. I have been helped out by different organizations in the Fargo-Moorhead area. The backpacks have like a really close, I guess it's really dear to my heart. So whenever I have a chance to volunteer for the backpacks, I always jump to do that. The first time that I came across the United Way backpack was when I was about 12 years old. So a young kid, my sister was 6. It was like, you know, like receiving like that best gift, you know, a backpack. And you know, my sister, both, you know, she was younger, of course, she was going to kindergarten. So to see her have a backpack, it made me feel much better. Having your, you know, your backpack, having the things inside of it that, you know, you need for your first day, that kind of sets the tone for how things will go in the future. Kids get so excited about going back to school. And when you don't have a backpack and you know that your family can't afford a backpack, it's not easy for a kid, you know, to be able to fit in. I'm just thankful that United Way, you know, Cascade is there to be able to help those families out, you know, help these kids out that truly need it. And for the community of Fargo-Moorhead, I feel like people are recognizing that there is a need, but there's so many more out there that could be helped. Now that I'm raising a kid of my own and just knowing that I can afford a backpack for her, I can afford the things that she needs, I know that I can dig up some funds and be able to afford a backpack for another kid out there that needs it. We are raising both of the kids to give back. We are raising them both to understand that not everyone has everything. I know where I came from. I was one of those kids that received that backpack back when I was 12 years old. It has helped me succeed in my life. It has helped me belong. And because of that sense of belonging, I was able to excel in my life and carry on and go get a college degree and now have a full-time job and work for border states. I mean, it's thanks to the stuff that I was able to receive as a child. I received help from the community, and hence why I want to do this for United Way. I mean, I feel like I'm giving back to United Way through this. I feel like sharing my story, I'm hoping that people realize that it's not just about a backpack. It's more than that. It's seeing that face, like that child's face light up when they have the things that they need to be able to excel in school. And couldn't just sit there and have like other kids go through that in a sense, because we're a small community. There should never be a kid without a backpack. We should never see a kid struggling in school because they don't have the essential things to be able to excel. We should be able to, you know, go out there and help one another. And we just have so much power, you know, to make a difference and to be able to help out our younger generation to do well.